Hello everyone and welcome to the Alice's Turbo Mesh Kit review. This is already quite old stuff, but I wanted to publish it anyway. I've also earlier published the review in a readable text form on my blog. Link is in the description. First things first, I'm not an experienced drummer. In fact, I bought the kit as my very first drum kit to start and learn the basics just to have some fun. However, playing music has been my hobby all my life and I've observed a lot of drummers up close, so I did have a basic idea how drums work when I started. Consider this review to have 3 points. How is the drum kit and cheap drum kits in general technically? How to set them up so as to get the best out of them? And how is a cheap drum kit like this for an absolute beginner if you just want to get started? After I had fiddled around 10 hours with the drums, I actually went to a workplace hobby band rehearsal to try out real drums for the very first time in my life. It was a bit shaky. As I mentioned, I had no prior experience with drums, only what I'd seen my bandmates play. After a few dozen hours more with the electronic drums, also the acoustic drum set started to feel more comfortable. I only played the acoustic set a couple of times during my first year as an aspiring drummer, but even then the limitations of electronic drums started to become quite obvious, especially in the cheaper price class. Although for the e-drums there were a few things on the plus side too. Some of the limitations include only a little bit of dynamics, not that many sounds, touch and feel are so-so. Some of the positive things include they can sound better than a really bad drum set, they don't take much space, and the sticks hardly wear at all. Some notes about the real-life noise level of the electronic drums. The mesh pads don't make that much noise. The hard plastic rims surrounding the meshes, on the other hand, are very, very loud. I took one of the pads apart and there isn't any real reason for the rims to be so high. One could maybe cut or grind them down a bit if they have the tools. The rubber cymbals do make quite a bit of sound. I actually added some shock absorbers to the hi-hat surface as it was a bit annoying in the beginning. The pedals make a terrible noise. I modified them a bit to make them much more quiet. I made a separate video about it on YouTube. Link is in the description. To help your neighbor downstairs and stop mechanical noise, especially from the pedals, a carpet underneath the drums is nice to have. I also added a piece of yoga mat underneath the pedals. This, along with the carpet, makes them quite wobbly though, so I ended up removing the mat. All in all, the total noise level is quite tolerable and would be fine, for example, for a child, if they are a bit too shy to make some noise with real drums. For a general idea about the noise level, check out the intro video again, this time with real sounds. Volume-wise, a hard hit to the drums sounds a bit like snapping your fingers, so not very loud. The pedals are spring-loaded with an on-off trigger just before bottoming out. If the pedals aren't on a hard surface, this might introduce problems with time and unregistered hits. The assembly is also under constant small stress when kicking the pedals. This stress eventually resulted in one of the legs of the tip ring sleeve jack to be broken and signal being cut, so the pedal didn't work anymore. The connection is actually just the tip and sleeve, so I fixed it with a jumper wire running from the ring to sleeve as shown in the picture. Can you make the pedals double kick pedals by connecting them on parallel? I tried a physical connection as shown in the picture. It doesn't quite work. As the pedals are on-off and there's a bit of an on area after the trigger, when the pedal is pressed down that is, if you try to pedal too quickly, the on time will overlap between the two pedals and kicks will fail to register from the other pedal. All the pads and cymbals are single hit area with a 6.3mm mono plug to connect them. The connecting cables all branch from a single connector other end that is connected to the controlling unit using a couple of screws. The mesh pads have just a single piezo electric element connecting to it a foam bridge, visible through the mesh. The hits register much harder nearer the element, but in practice it didn't seem to matter much. Opening a pad reveals that the base of the pad has places for multiple screws in the middle. I've seen in some more expensive pads a single piezoelectric element but with multiple foam bridges leading to it, averaging the hit power over the mesh. Hence, it might be that the same pad base is used in more expensive models. The cymbals probably have a single piezo also. You also cannot mute the cymbals because of this, as they only detect hits, not pressure of your pinching fingers. The drums seem to have a slight problem of hits not 100% always registering, be it a cymbal, a pad, or a pedal. Fortunately, it's not a common problem and doesn't matter when practicing, but recording or performing it might be a real issue. The drum stand is quite sturdy and has good build quality. I also made some wooden keyboard holders for it to save space and the stand feels strong enough. The drone is not included in the set. It's worth spending some money to get a good sturdy drone. It makes practicing nice and comfortable. The stock sounds are in my opinion quite bad. They aren't of that great quality sample-wise, for example there might be some noise or they might just sound weird. The worst feature, however, is how unbalanced they are volume-wise. For example, in some sample sets the cymbals are hardly heard and there's no way to tune the balance. In the video I go through all the stock sounds. And here's the intro video again, but this time with the default drum sounds. There's also some quite audible noise from the headphone jack. I got tired of it pretty quickly, so it might actually be an issue when practicing. The sample is recorded from the headphone jack. The Alesis Turbo has a USB B-type connector. It is seen by the computer as a standard USB MIDI interface. To see what kind of MIDI data comes out of it, I used ALSA raw MIDI ports via the AMIDI tool. One important thing I noticed is that the hi-hat always sends the open hi-hat note. The state of the pedal is sent as MIDI data just before the hi-hat note data. I have no idea how well this kind of behavior is supported in different digital audio workstations and other software. I used the Hydrogen drum machine to play the sound samples, but it didn't have support for such pedal behavior. In the video, I play the hi-hat with and without the pedal, from MIDI command tables and percussion keymap, and by doing some hexadecimal to decimal conversion, we are able to decode the debug data. Therefore, to get the hi-hat working correctly, your software needs to react to the B9047F foot controller on MIDI message before playing the hi-hat note. Since I had the hi-hat pedal problem with Hydrogen, I had to do some transforming to the MIDI messages sent by the drums before they reach Hydrogen. For that, I used the MIDI-ding software, which is a MIDI router and processor. The link is in the description. I wrote a custom MIDI-ding script and a shell script to fire everything up, including a reverb effect using Jackrack. Using MIDI-dings, it's also easy to have one of the cymbals work both as a ride cymbal and a crash cymbal, depending on the hit force, so you almost get one more cymbal for free. The double kick pedal conversion is also possible with software. The script files are available on my GitHub page. The link is in the description. When I start the shell script and wait a couple of seconds, some applications and connections open up on my desktop. The shell script prompt, cue jack control, Hydrogen, Jackrack, and a jack connections graph. Playing the drums then is a matter of launching one shortcut. To answer the question, are cheap electronic drums any good for learning to play? I would say the short answer is yes. Playing the drums requires so much fine motorical skills and possibly rewiring your brain to make your legs and arms play together, or not together, that it doesn't really matter that much what kind of equipment you use to practice the very basics. What is immediately obvious when compared to a real drum set is that the musicality side, nuances, different sounds and the playing feel, are severely limited by the drums being electronic and the more so the cheaper the drums. That being said, for someone starting to play, I don't feel like those are the first in the list of priorities. The first in the list should be, is it fun to play? And for that, I would definitely answer yes. And if you are tech savvy, with a bit of work, you will get a lot more out of your cheap electronic drums than you'd expect.